Yo, what's up guys? Welcome back to today's video. In today's video, we're going to be getting the Colorado from right there, over there. You see it? Sad little poor little girl. Anyways, we're not gonna touch the truck yet, but there's steps to this, trust the process, and join along for the ride. Now this is the engine that originally came out of the Yukon, and it is iron block 5.3, and it is completely stock at the moment. So I finally am gonna do something with the engine. I'm extremely excited, and it's been a while of doing a lot of parts stacking, so I've got like a bunch of parts still on the way and here, and at this point we are finally ready to take this engine apart and finally get ready to take it onto the machine shop. So let's get right into it. Man, this thing's freaking heavy, bro. Man, I should have got an aluminum block 5.3. Why the hell am I over here dealing with this damn thing?
All right, so as of right now, I don't know exactly when it is you guys watching this video. So right now, in time being, just to give you like a time frame, right now my dad still hasn't even put the seats in the boat yet. Like, he still hasn't even put the seats in the boat yet. What is he doing? So what I'm thinking is it might be a while from now that you guys actually see this footage, and I just want to let you guys know that I'm trying my best, and my pockets are most definitely trying their best to go ahead and afford to do this all as fast as possible, but the correct way, and so I don't have to redo it again. I want so badly for the Colorado to be on the road, and I want so badly for the Colorado to be out there gapping fools, because trust me, that's what we all want to see. And that's exactly what we're gonna get with this project. So definitely sticking for the ride, bro. We're gonna get there sooner or later. So I need to create a pile of like parts that I'm not gonna, sorry y'all can't see. I'm gonna create a pile of parts that I want to take to get hot tanks so that I get rid of all the stuff that's on there now. So this crank pulley, I wanna reuse it. I mean, there's no reason for me not to reuse it. I mean, I'm not trying to buy a $300 harmonic balancer, which I mean, it's great and all, don't get me wrong, but $300 right now? It should go away. Definitely gonna take that pulley with us. I'm definitely gonna get a new bolt there for the hardware side. Ah, fuck. We got a vacuum, so we're gonna go ahead and get rid of all the leaves and dust and stuff out of the cylinder. Firstly, we're gonna start off by taking the timing cover off. You know, we're gonna use this Summit box I got right here. This little Summit box right here that some of my parts came in. Y'all see that stuff shortly. Just go ahead. We'll just toss that in there
because we don't need that stuff no more. Maybe, maybe not. I don't know, maybe if I cheap out a little bit, build another one.
I need my box. Where my box go? I need my box close by so I don't have to walk.
Okay, this is whenever issue number one comes into play. So, I was thinking, you know what? Whenever I was gonna go to Cam in Colorado, let me save some money. Let me reuse the cam from the Yukon, and you have a cammed engine without having to do way too much and buy way too much parts, right? Well, wrong.
Give me one of my bolts back.
A little trick. I mean, I know it's kind of, you know, obvious, but you know, just put a little butt one there. Yeah, just screw that bad boy in there. Just use that sucker to pull the whole thing out. So, this is when the problem comes and starts to happen. So, initially you would think that a camshaft will slide straight out. But when you have the issue that I'm having here with mine, can you see that? You see that little edge right there on the edge of the cam? I know it's probably difficult to see. You see that? Well, that right there, bud, that right there is not good. So that actually is a cam bearing stuck to the camshaft. So now I think to myself, how in the world am I supposed to get a cam out that doesn't even allow you to go past the cam other cam bearings? So that is kind of what the point of this whole situation is. It's trying to figure out how do I get this big old Johnson out of this little old hole. The pullout game sucks. I gotta get this damn oil pan off. I think it might fit in the cup. I guess we'll find out.
This might be the stupidest thing I could possibly do,
but it'll make for a funny clip, so.
Let's see exactly how much oil we have in here. It could be dry. Could be. Possibly.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, drier than a grandma. Hey, look at this. Ah, what the hell is that? Oh, a bunch of metal shavings. Oh my God. Oh my God, I damn near look like Picasso in the middle of this cup now. God damn it. It's not supposed to be like that.
Now, if I get some oil on this ground and my father asks, it wasn't me. It was someone else. It wasn't me. I don't know. Maybe he's editing this video. I don't know. I don't know.
All right, let's see if I can flip this bad boy around all by myself. This shit is kind of heavy. God damn. Damn, Gina. This boy fat. This boy fat. Hopefully no oil comes. No! Alright, guys. Oh, shit! Get the red Solo cup! Guys, there's oil on the ground. My father's gonna kill me.
Man, nothing ever just works out perfectly fine the first time.
Coming out of the coolant passages.
I always gotta put myself through this. I knew it was gonna make a mess. Why would I even try? Anyways, don't tell my father. I know he's gonna know.
Okay, bad timing, but I made a mess. Uh-oh. Oh, shit. He might have caught me. God damn it. I could have cleaned it up. Hurry, run.
It's like putting a Band-Aid on a bullet hole.
Oh, this ain't oil. It's just cooling. Well, that's black.
Is that Tubby? Hi, Tubby. Where you going, Tubby?
Tubby didn't want me.
You better go shit, you motherfucker.
Was he farting?
The whole goddamn time. I didn't know you were recording.
What y'all doing?
Dude, he was fucking the Suburban up.
Bro. Oh, yeah. New string?
It's purdy.
Damn.
Good stuff.
You're gonna snap that thing like 10 times before I ever get this video posted.
Oh, you got some weights and hooks. And
thought it was a bag of milk duds.
Things.
Yeah. Not a bag of milk duds. Yeah. It's goddamn weights. They got them back. Hey, yeah. Toby.
Go poop.
Come here, boy. Come here, boy.
Here's a lot. I smell McDonald's.
No. Alright.
You need my tripod for now.
I didn't make a mess.
You didn't make a mess?
I told you he was gonna find out. Okay, I told him. But the truth is, he was gonna find out either way. He was gonna yell at me either way. So might as well make it a joke.
Man, now we gotta. We need one of those, like, y'all ever seen those oil pan things that, like, attach to the cart? Why don't we have one of those? Attempt number two. Hey, look, it's a goddamn Tubby. Attempt numero dos, number two, to, take this oil pan off without making a mess. No promises.
Where the bucket at?
Tubby, move. You don't get on dirty, dude.
For some reason, these bolts are loose.
I don't remember taking those off. I really don't remember taking these off. That one sounded true. This one got water in it. Oh, dang. For some reason, I don't feel very confident in not making a mess right now. Why is this side tight and that side wasn't? To be fair, I never put this this pan gasket on here, so it wasn't me. Oh my God, there's not enough room around here for this. Well, I feel like there's a chance I'm missing a bolt, but. Yeah, I wasn't missing a bowl.
I got this dirty old dusty oil pan out, which, disclaimer, I will tell you this right now. We're most likely reusing this, because, why not? I mean, what the hell I need anything special for? It's not like I'm going to be making 1,000 horsepower.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, this thing's got some serious grease issues.
Why does his linens look so goddamn dirty? Now that the oil pan's out of the way, I just got to get rid of this pickup tube so I can take the oil pump off as well.
Those are 19s.
Oh, great.
It's goddamn hot in here.
Oh, dude.
I'm over here complaining about it being hot, but the goddamn swamp cooler right here, I forget this thing freaking works. All right, let me turn this on. And my battery's flashing, so let me go ahead and switch that up real quick.
Swamp cooler on now, so now I can continue to do this without sweating my cojones off. Damn, what the hell?
Bro,
One of these days, I'm gonna cut all my hair off. Okay.
But today is not the day because the girls love the curls.
Copy. Oh, my hands are all gross.
Oh, no good, my friend. No good.
I got to figure out how to take this cover off. I'm gonna chuck it. Oh, haha. I forgot, there's plugs in here. Ah, I did it right. Look, I did it right. Hey, I'm learning. I really gotta take those off.
God.
I could've just did it right. I always learn the hard way through things, man. Yay. Yay, that was easy. Get the oil pressure sensor out. Yay. Get it?
Do y'all get it? Cause they're knock sensors? Knock knock.
Okay, now to turn this thing upside down, but I don't know what's going on with the whole leaking thing, so we're gonna take it out back. I don't need these on here. I just realized that my dumb self didn't take them off yet. Okay, add to the parts box. Now that it's out back, we're gonna go ahead and just flip it over here. I mean, the concrete's nice and pretty, so we're gonna mess that up. No, I really don't think that it's oil that's in here, because clearly I have the oil pan out, and it came out of the coolant passage. You see where it's wet right here? Focus. Where it's wet right here? That clearly is from, like, from the coolant. You know what? I'll just push it over the edge. Push me over the edge! All my friends are dead! I'm just wrong. Let's question ourselves. What is this piece of metal that just fell out of here? I really hope I didn't find something. Well, I mean, I hope I found it now, but I really hope I didn't mess something up too bad. There's definitely some more pieces. God damn it. All right, so now that I get inside of the block, it seems like there's a chance that I don't know if they should be having that much movement in there. I don't know. But as you see, metal in there, definitely spun rod bearings as well as cam bearings. See that metal shaving? Oh, no bueno. No bueno. So we're gonna go ahead and inspect the damage. But I really don't want to have to buy another block. That would suck. Alright, so that is not a fun process. This thing don't even spin freely by hand. This is absolutely lovely. Really hope I don't keep finding damage. But this is one of my cam bearings. Don't ask me why it looks like this. And it's supposed to be two pieces. And I'll go through and show you all the pistons right now as well, but they're all crapped. So right now we're gonna pull this crank out all the way and then check the damage and see if there's any damage between the main caps. And if we just keep finding damage, and it's almost worth it just to use a different block, we'll end up just going that route. I don't want to have to do that because I don't have to purchase a block, but, what can we really do? All right, now time to pull this crank out. This has not been fun. And this is about to be
moment of truth of whether we can use this block or not. All right, as of right now, I got the whole block taken apart. Look at this. And sorry about that.
I'm gonna get Cheeto on him. Oh, that little fucker ran fast.
Cheeto would have caught him. Anyways, I got the whole block taken apart. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and continue with the plan of using this block. I don't know 100% if I'm going to or not, but luckily, now that I work at Hughes Performance, which is, you know, the banner in the background, they have a hot tank there. And I talked to the boss, Jeff. His name is Jeff Hughes, of course. He's going to end up letting me use the hot tank there. So tomorrow I'm going to show you guys exactly the whole process of going through the hot tank. Maybe show you guys a little bit of a process of some of the things that they do in the shop. But yeah, so we're going to hot tank the block tomorrow. The pile of parts right here, we're going to hot tank with them as well. Just to get everything all cleaned up and basically ready to be built. I don't know 100% if I'm gonna use this block yet, but I'm gonna take it over to the machine shop. They do have spare core blocks that they can sell me. I definitely need a new crank. Let me show you guys the crank. The crank is no bueno, not good at all. It's hard to focus, but there's only like one that's clean. It's this one. The rest of them all have engraved marks in them and stuff. So as of right now, I'm just going to go ahead and continue on with the plan. Hit it with the super clean. It's not the best lighting, but it's okay. It's gonna work. We're not trying to make this thing perfect or look brand new or nothing like that. We're just gonna go ahead and hit the whole thing with some super clean, get it to where it's not like leaking a bunch of oil and everything like that, and all the rest of the work will go to the hot tank. Damn. If your degreaser don't make you choke, then it's a joke. So we're gonna let it dry overnight. In the morning, we're gonna load it up and take it into work with me. And then we'll just go from there. So I'll see you all in the morning. Peace. What's up, guys? So it's currently the next morning. I'm about ready to get going for work. Here's the block. It's just sitting out here. It did kind of rust up the cylinder wall just a little bit, but it is what it is. I don't really mind. Like I said, it's gonna get hot tanked today. So what I'm gonna do is go ahead and put it back on this little cart and get this thing wheeled up out front so we can load it up in the car. Haven't decided whether we're gonna take Marcus's car today or we're gonna take the Yukon today. So let's just get it out front and get it ready. I have some other little parts and stuff that I want to take with me as well. I gotta start getting all this stuff loaded up into the Yukon because we were gonna take Marge's car, but this fool's always freaking late. He's always late. Oh my god, he never comes on time. Don't tell him I told you that. Got everything loaded up, ready to go. Basically just gotta head to work. Usually me and Marcus ride together, but today he's he has to do something right after work, so just ride separately today. Yeah, on our way to work now. Man, it's hot. What's up, guys? So currently it is after work. I already got off of work. I just wanted to, I know last clip I said I was gonna do some stuff at work today. Well, I ended up showing the block to a few of my coworkers, and a lot of the guys there, they're really knowledgeable when it comes down to engine building. Even though it is a transmission shop, they're all racers, bro. They've all built engines, they've all done everything.
of the sort. And I showed them basically what was happening with my block, and they were like, honestly, bro, if you're trying to make the kind of power that you're going for in this thing, I would just get a new block. So sadly, at the moment, I just decided not to hot tank this block. I said, screw it. This block, because the cam bearing's actually spinning on the inside of the block, that it's gonna cost me more money to fix this one. I mean, I'm not gonna get rid of this block. I mean, there's no reason for me to. I'm not gonna just toss it out or nothing like that. But I actually did find a block that's a lot better condition than mine on Facebook Marketplace. Which you guys know, those Facebook Marketplace deals are always, they're always good. So I'm actually gonna go check out this now. I'm gonna pick up Marcus from his house, and then we're gonna go straight over there. It's about a 30-minute drive, so it's really nice outside right now. Surprisingly, it's super nice. Integra, nice. But anyways, yeah. So we're gonna go ahead and get on the way. What's up, Marky Mark? How you doing? All right. So it's a few days after the last clip. I currently just picked up some heads from one of our coworkers. These are 243 heads that I'm going to be sending out to get CNC ported, etc. So right now we're about to run them through the steam washer over here, and now we're going through and sending them through the parts washer. This kind of just goes through, going through and cleaning them up. Got my boy working out here.
Yep, master got me.
Yes, sir. Master got me walking. No, just lying. But hell yeah, about to pass these through. 243 heads, and then we're gonna get these actually packaged up and ready to ship out, because these are going over to Borowski's Race Engines. If anyone has heard of them or hasn't, go ahead and look them up. Super dope company. They have a lot going on with LSs and all that kind of stuff, super high horsepower stuff. I did contact them, and they are going to record some clips for you guys of actually the process of getting these heads ready to go. They are going to do a full CNC port, intake and exhaust side, and then also a complete valve job on them as well. So let's go ahead and pass these bad boys through. Hit that button. Pull the switch, Igor.
I do some working out here, bro.
Get used to it, bud. Office boy.
Office boy's favorite.
So I'm gonna take these over to shipping department so they can get them boxed up and do that expansion foam around it, so it's actually all freaking perfect inside of a box. I'm shipping it out on a pallet with one of the transmissions that we're sending over to them to be good to go from there. So go ahead and go and take these to the shipping department now and ask them to box it up for me. They're probably gonna say no. Yo, what's up, guys? So a few days have passed again. Well, I mean, there's not really much rhyme or rhythm to how many days this video is actually gonna take to record. But currently, I got all of the rotating assembly and everything in. So I have forged piston rods and then some rings that were custom made for boost, etc. So there's some good stuff in here. I could kind of give you guys a glimpse. This isn't open, so I'm not gonna open it. But here's the rods here. Some H-Beam Compstar Cali's rods. So I was told that these are really good rods to run, so I ended up picking these up. And then it's pretty heavy. Some nice pistons as well, some forged pistons as well, as you can tell. They are flat top, and they do have valve reliefs in them. So you'll see all of that in more detail whenever we actually do pick up the engine from the machine shop. But this is currently just a little glimpse. I'm gonna load everything up in this bag real quick. We're loading everything up right now to take it to the machine shop. It is a very well-known guy out here in Arizona. All right,
Alright guys, so I got a few more parts. I got the ARP main studs. I got King's bearings. These are going to be the piston and main bearings. And then I also got the crank. And then I have another crank as well. I'm going to take both of them. Whichever one's the best one is the one we're going to use. This is a 58X reluctor wheel. The other one is a 24X reluctor wheel. Whichever one's the best, we're going to throw and put the 24X on it. Pretty sure this one's mint condition, ready to go. So I'm pretty sure we're going to use this one. I just got to load everything up in the Tegra.
Also have to bring the guy a down payment. I completely spaced on bringing it whenever I went and dropped off all the other stuff. So in order for him to start, he just needs a down payment. And then so I'm about ready to get all these parts loaded up, and then go spend some money. A little bit of parts. Man, these things are freaking heavy.
All right, let's go ahead and get on the road now. I'm gonna go get a new battery for this camera because this thing is about ready to die, so.
What up, guys? I'm taking over the video. You wanna know why? Because Braven didn't record an outro for this. I'm over here editing and I'm like, okay, Braven, you left to the machine shop. The end. Good news is everything's already back from the machine shop, and we are gonna make the sacrifice, man. We're gonna make the sacrifice of taking this nice shrink wrap off for you guys to actually see his block. So appreciate it. Make sure you smash the like button for that, because Braven's gonna actually take the saran wrap off. This thing's been sitting in his bedroom for a couple of days now since he got it back.
It's been a nightstand.
A nightstand, yeah, I noticed that. Yeah, do you set your phone on it at night?
Yeah.
Yeah?
I do.
That's funny.
It's funny how it like absorbs the noise of my alarm though, because I don't ever wake up.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
So, I don't know where exactly this video is at. Oh, you know what? This video that you're watching right now, I'm pretty sure is going to come before all of this.
Wow.
In the beginning of this video, he is tearing down his iron block that came out of the Yukon, and it turned out that the thing ain't nothing more than a paperweight. So, but it is very useful to use for a mock-up engine, you know what I'm saying? In which that's what he's been doing out here. So there's a local guy here that a lot of people, I guess, actually use. We had never heard of him. We've heard of him now. Braven learned of him through some co-workers over at Hughes. A guy named Shammy. He does all the machine work and everything at his house. He has a pretty dope setup, man, inside of his personal garage. He has everything that you need to machine engines, which was pretty dope. So got hooked up with that guy, went down there, and Shammy luckily had a bunch of core blocks, and he had this one, which Braven purchased a new block from him, and had him do all the machine work on it. Give us a moment to get this thing unwrapped. Braven's gonna try to do it in a way that he's able to reuse the shrink wrap, because we do have some, but I don't know if it's gonna be enough to rewrap the entire engine. Dun dun dun. This is the sacrifice, man. There's absolutely no reason to do this other than to let you guys see the block. None whatsoever.
I had no problems with this sitting there in my room.
So what's the plan for assembly?
So I'm planning on assembling it once I have actually like all the parts to assemble and make it a closed engine. I wasn't wanting it to be assembled and then collecting dust and by opening it up like this kind of situation. Yeah. I'd rather assemble it all whenever it's all just right in front of
a long block with the heads and everything.
Heads, everything.
So the heads went out to
Borowski's
race engines.
Yep.
Do you know when those are going to be back?
They should be coming back within the next week or so.
Yeah, so you should be getting the heads back within the next week or so, which is good. Which is huge. I don't know if you guys are aware of this, but those guys, like, go to their website, man, and check them out. They have 4,500 horsepower LSs available to purchase. I think they're like $80,000, but.
Yeah, not too bad. I asked my coworkers and they said, why don't you just buy one of their engines? I was like, blah, blah, blah. Yeah. I was like, yeah, I would love to.
Well, I was looking at them. They have some pretty, I mean, they do have some affordable stuff. They have like a budget 6.0 setup.
Yeah.
That was like 13,000, something like that.
Yeah, it's not bad.
Which isn't crazy. Like, people are having to put fucking $20,000 blocks to make that kind of power with a K-series.
No, for sure, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, but yeah, here's the big news. Braven got an aluminum block. Watch out for my light, bro.
Cut my aluminum.
Damn. Damn.
So what, this is a LC9, you said?
It is an LC9, so it's an aluminum 5.3. For instance, I just carry this out of my bedroom by myself.
Yeah.
Kind of, you know what I'm saying? I mean, once it's fully assembled, I won't be able to carry it by myself, but it's still, like they say, it's around 120 to 150 pounds, somewhere in between there. I've heard multiple different numbers, but it's in that range.
It's a lot lighter.
Lighter than the steel, or yeah. cast iron.
Than the iron block, yeah. So yeah, that should definitely help. Yeah, but fresh from the machine shop, and what did you have done with the head studs? They drilled them out?
They drilled them out and re-tapped them for half inch head stud. So you run half inch head studs on aluminum blocks, so they're able to handle more boost.
Yeah.
So that's the problem with running an aluminum block, is going to be basically the head like to lift on them because of just the heat, warpage, etc. So I was told just to run the half inch head stud upgrade, which it has the half inch head stud upgrade on it. And it is basically, it is bored over, it is decked, honed, full rotating assembly, like it was all rotated and everything like that. So it is ready to go, ready
balanced.
To be
balanced. The whole rotating assembly was balanced.
Yeah, so it was all basically ready to go. I was just, like I said, waiting until I got all the parts.
Yeah, exactly.
So there it is, man. He got an aluminum block, LC9, the whole forged rotating assembly has been balanced. He is running a factory crank, but the crank has obviously been balanced with the rotating assembly, and it's been polished and everything. So it's gonna be a pretty dope setup, dude.
She gonna be a monster, boy.
Anyhow, guys, that's where Braven's paychecks have been going for the last few months, is in all this stuff. He's also, I don't know if he told you, but he's gonna be running a Turbo 400 transmission on the truck, obviously built by Hughes. So yeah, it's gonna be a pretty serious setup, man. With that being said, if there's any fabricators out there that wanna work with us and make a video on caging this boy's truck, because I know cages can be very expensive.
Yeah. I have a cage on the way. It's kind of just how I'll put it, is I have it on the way or in the works to be on the way. So basically what I'm gonna wanna do is I'm gonna get everything else done on the frame first before putting the cab on. Get the cab on, and then just tack it all the way up. So whenever the person that does decide to fabricate it or weld it, they just weld it. So they'll already do all the hard work and everything like that.
Yeah, so basically he's getting a weld-in cage and probably wants somebody with a little bit more experience in welding than him or me to actually weld it in properly to make sure it ain't gonna move, you know what I'm saying? But anyhow, guys, gonna go ahead and end this video here. I'm gonna end Braven's video here. I hope you guys enjoyed following him along with this. Plans changed inside of this video, in which I think they changed for the better, because you were originally going with an iron block.
They were, yeah. I was originally going with an iron block, and there was not much of a price difference in going to the aluminum block.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, the block itself, I'll say I paid
cheap
in comparison to finding
cheap.
An iron
Chamois took care of
it. Yeah, he took care of me for sure.
I couldn't find that block for less than $1,000.
Yeah, so
just a block.
I definitely saved money on that end.
All right, guys, later. Adios there, Ruggy.
Later, guys.
You want to lean down?
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.